just wanted to cover this article. It makes a couple of significant statements. The first one is that people with methylation problems, it is a significant issue, and not just in terms of mental health. It's a significant increased risk for diabetic eye disease. Another point that it makes is that you can do something for diabetic eye disease, and it's a supplement. A supplement does have a significant impact. It's a methylfolate supplement. So let's get into the article and see a little bit more about what's going on. It was in Eye and Vision in 2019. I believe it was just a couple of months ago, July 2019. Improving diabetic and hypertensive retinopathy with a medical food containing L-methylfolate, a preliminary report. This is just a case series, so it's not a randomized clinical trial. It's not that advanced yet. They go on and start out mentioning homocysteine. High homocysteine is a marker for methylation problems. Vitamin D is, they mention vitamin D as maybe playing a role as well. And so they went in and gave a supplement that has methylfolate, the B vitamins methylated, and vitamin D. In addition to some AREDS components, which AREDS, as you know, age-related eye disease, those are antioxidants. Methylation is a method of achieving antioxidation as well. So they gave a significant supplement. One of them is actually even a medical food. I won't get into the differences, but it has to do with actually even requiring a prescription for it. Now, there are three different names you'll see for this. One is iFolate, one is Restore Me, one is Restore V. Actually, four names. Another name is Ocufolin. L-methylfolate in it was 2.7 milligrams and 3.0 milligrams, respectively. And vitamin D3 was 4,500 international units each, just below that 5,000 that you see as an average recommendation for most of us. As you see on this slide, it's an AREDS combination, you know, vitamin C, D, E, and the B complex, as well as the zinc oxide, and the zinc is found in AREDS as well, as well as a couple of other things like alpha-lipoic acid, lutein, and acetylcysteine, remember, with the precursor for glutathione. So again, all looking at antioxidant activities. This shows the genetics of the individuals in this case series. As you see, there six of the eight were MTHFR, people with methylation problems. The C677T variation. We also have some with A1298C. You don't need to know those numbers. Obviously, I don't know them. I keep tripping over them. I actually have these, by the way. I've worked with a genetics lab for about 5 years, and so was able to get a lot of my genetics at low to no cost for me. So I'm one of those people in that 40% category who has up to 70% challenges in terms of methylation. Again, one of the important ways of getting reduction, recharging those live embers that are lying around your mitochondria, the furnaces of your cell, lying there oxidized. So again, that's where that comes from. But let's take a look at some of the pictures. Obviously, you don't have to be an ophthalmologist to see the improvement here. These red spots, these significant improvement there. I'll show you a couple of others as well. Again, very obvious improvement in the eye. Now, one thing I would mention is that biologically, the eye is behind what we call the blood-brain barrier. So quite often we can't get medications or supplements or other things beyond a thing called the blood-brain barrier. Why does that matter? Well, think about it. The eye is very much a reflection of what's going on in the brain. Or it can be. And the logic here is, you know, does this have any impact on development of cognitive decline or brain function? Don't know the answer to that. But again, as you can see, we continue to go through images. This is a cross-section of retinal tissue. And as you can see here, much improved thickness and density of the retinal tissue. You'll see that over and over in these videos. Is it the state of the absolute best research? No, the absolute best research, randomized clinical trials haven't been done yet on those. Is it enough to make me think twice? Yeah, I'm starting to take this very same supplement, and we'll be offering it at some point if we can get our program together. This may seem like a very unusual eye. This eye's already had some surgery in terms of supporting that retina. That's what these blotches are. Now, let's go on down here and make another point that they made in the study. They actually measured retinal blood flow velocity. And as you can see, you got significant improvements in both arterioles, the tiniest arteries, and venules, the tiniest veins, after 6 months of supplementation. So AREDS has been demonstrated many times all over the world. The eye center in Miami has been a major center for investigating AREDS itself. This is something that's similar, but not quite the same. It includes AREDS as well as methylfolate. If you've made it this far, thank you very much for your interest. If plaque is the number one cause of heart attack, stroke, dementia, blindness, kidney disease, you'd think we'd know how to evaluate it, screen for it, wouldn't you? Unfortunately, the state of the art right now is a guess, and a bad one at that, Framingham. The most common thing that you do is you say, well, hey doc, why don't we do a stress test? They don't work either. Then you go into the cath lab and get a definitive test, but that involves getting a needle in the groin. It just goes downhill from there. Now, there are better ways. Take a look at our plaque evaluation course. Click the link below.